Thank you. Please be seated. Good evening. I am John Downs, Superintendent of the Hallsville School District. On behalf of the Board of Education, Administration, faculty, and staff, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you to the commencement ceremony for the Hallsville High School Class of 2022. Accomplishments of these outstanding young adults as they complete one chapter of their lives and begin another. We also acknowledge the shared efforts of everyone in attendance this evening. Whether a parent, a teacher, a family member, or a friend, you have played an important role in the success of these graduates. The students and all of us at the school wish to recognize you and express our gratitude. Time and again, the Hallsville community has demonstrated overwhelming support and dedication to providing excellent schools. Your continued commitment ensures that we are able to provide a quality education for each student, preparing them for life beyond the classroom. For this, we are also deeply grateful. Thank you. The best evidence of our school's quality is seated before you this evening. These students demonstrate a range of talents and achievements that seem almost limitless. This group of seniors includes Quiz Bowl members who won our 10th district championship in a row and finished fourth at state, members who helped secure our first ever national FFA Silver Emblem chapter designation, three seniors who placed in Skills USA career and technical education competitions, band and choir members who earned exemplary ratings at district and state music contests, a Missouri Scholars 100 recipient, cheer squad members who took first place in the fight song division of state competition, athletes who won district championships in volleyball, football, girls basketball, and baseball, along with state qualifiers in speech and debate, FBLA, cross country, and track and field. Here to tell you, that's not even a complete list. So many academic scholarships were awarded this morning, I lost count. This is an amazing group of well-rounded and talented individuals who are living, breathing reminders of what a supportive and committed community provides to its young people. Hallsville High School Class of 2022, this is your day. As you move on to your next phase of life, always remember that all of us are tremendously proud of you, your hard work, and your achievements, including those behind you and the many more still in your future. We celebrate your successes and wish you the best in all you do. Congratulations.
To introduce our first senior speaker, Jay Allen.
Well, hello everyone. Welcome friends, families, teachers, and all other significant members of our stories. I hope you all have had a good night so far without too many emotions coming out yet. I'd like to start off by saying thank you to parents and teachers for dealing with us throughout the past 13 years. You have helped morph each and every one of us into who we are today. And yeah, I know, you all say, it's our job, it's because we love you, and stuff like that. But really, thank you. In one moment, and all of us are here today because of your hard work. So give yourselves a nice round of applause. But this isn't about you. It's about us. It is our time to shine, and Miss Howard told me I had to give her credit for that line, so there you go. Now, I'm not about to go on and on about all the stuff with the think is cool. Every single one of you has something that makes you wake up in the morning and continues to let it define you day after day. And a thing can be anything. It can be a sport, a club, a story, a subject. It can be anything. And all of you, no matter how old or how young, can turn that anything into something that makes your life feel more complete. We are fortunate enough to live in one of the greatest countries in the world. We can go anywhere we want. We can live wherever we want. We can do whatever we want. You can do whatever you want. You can take that thing that defines you and turn it into something that completes your life. A man once told me a story about one of his friends. He told me that his friend was walking around a city and he saw a street performer on a small wooden board in the middle of a sidewalk. As his friend watched the performer, he jumped, and all he had to say was, 36, 36, 36, 36, and that's all he did. And as the guy got closer, he noticed there was a big crowd around him, and they were watching and laughing, so this guy was curious, so he walked over, and as he watched, the guy kept standing there, jumping on the board, 36, 36, 36, 36, and people were paying this guy. He had a hut full of money and everything else. So as he continued watching, a big guy came over and watched this guy jump. So, as the guy was jumping, mid-36, the guy pushed him over and started jumping on the board. As the big guy jumped, he'd go 36, 36, 36, 36. And as he kept jumping, the small guy got up, brushed himself off, walked over to the big guy, and as the big guy was mid-jump, he removed the board, and there was a manhole. The man fell straight through. As the man got up, he put the board over and started jumping again. 37, 37, 37, 37. If this guy, who none of you knew before tonight, and probably never will be, if he can do a big enough thing that I can talk about him at a graduation speech, if he can entertain us using only a board and a friend, then all of you can take your thing and make it into something. But it will be difficult. Nobody gets to achieve their dreams easily, but that's good. It's good that you can't achieve everything you want in one try. It is good that you can't do everything you want in one weekend. It is good that you may fail, because if you don't have that risk, then is there really any reward? In sports, we cheer when we win because there's a risk of losing to the other team. In class, we celebrate getting an A because there's a chance of failing. We celebrate good, normal weather here because every other day is a new forecast every hour. You don't celebrate anything that you get easily, at least not for very long. In track, you remember the races you worked for, not the ones you won without a challenge. This year, I beat the 800-meter run school record, and I will remember that race, not because I beat the record, but because I felt every second of that race. It was probably the worst thing I've ever had to do. But I felt like I'd actually done something worthwhile. I had accomplished something that I cared about, and I didn't even win the race. No, I got second place to another guy who beat his school record. But that race has been, if not one of my favorite races, because it hurt. And that I was able to beat that hurt. It's not in us to feel accomplished without some sort of challenge, but enjoy those challenges, as bad as they may be. Tell yourself they're good. You broke your arm? Good. You didn't get the job you wanted? Good. You have to pay taxes? Good. You've reached a dead end in your current position? Good. No matter what happens in your life, look up and say good. Because if you can't say good, you can still go on. As soon as you let your mind give up and say that you failed, that's when you've really lost. Life is hard. Work is hard. Taxes are hard. Adulting is hard. And it'll probably get harder and harder the older we get. But if each and every one of you can focus on the problem and just say good, then you're one step closer to fixing that problem. And then you are one step closer to making the thing that makes you into something that you can do for the rest of your life. Thank you.
Our second speaker, Jadrian Lynch.
Here in front of all actually been through a lot together, really tough times, and we all came out okay, I think. So I've been a part-time student at Hallsville for both my junior and senior years, doing a cosmetology program in the morning and coming to Hallsville in the afternoon. And let me tell you, I am beyond grateful that our school offers this program. If I didn't go to the Heart Career Center, I genuinely don't think I would be as successful as I have been over the past 2 years. Cosmetology has taught me so much beyond hair. It taught me how to carry myself, and it's taught me in the real world, the secret to success is faking it. I've always felt like the phrase, fake it till you make it, was a bunch of baloney. But I've noticed this year, the more I act like I know what I'm doing, the more I actually know what I'm doing. Not only with hair, but just everyday circumstances. My teacher, Mrs. Crow, has been an inspiration for me for my past 2 years. I am incredibly grateful to have had her as my mentor. I would also like to thank my teachers, Mrs. Langford, Mrs. Mack, Mrs. Williamson, Mr. Heat, Mrs. Lloyd, Sally, Coach Trisha Williams, Mr. Brett Williams, and Mr. Daly for making my high school experience fun and for believing in me when I couldn't. Of course, all of Hallsville's staff is beyond incredible. However, these 10 people have left a permanent mark on my life. You guys are the reason I continue to show up, and I'm eternally grateful for you. I'd also like to thank my wonderful family for letting me be me and supporting me every step of the way. I wouldn't be as strong as I am without you. I've been in a rush for as long as I can remember, especially when it came to school. I'd count the periods up until 3:15, dividing every hour into two sets of 30 minutes, and dividing that into four sets of 15 minutes. Once that bell rang, I was practically sprinting to get home. Now looking back, I wish it would stop to some flowers or something cliche every once in a while. I will say I'll be leaving the school that early tonight. I went through hundreds of quotes about change and new beginnings, and frankly, they were all very corny and repetitive. But this one by F. Scott Fitzgerald sat really well with me. It's never too late to become who you want to be. I hope you live a life you're proud of, and if you find that you're not, I hope you have the strength to start over. I urge you to take this advice and keep it forever. You are the only person responsible for your future and who you become. No matter if you make straight A's or C's and D's, we are all fortunate to have the chance to be successful and follow our dreams. I can promise you that 20 years from now, it will not matter that we flunked that history test or turned in that math and work late, but what will matter is that if you're happy with where and who you are. To the students moving on to college, that's amazing, and we are so happy for you. And for the students that are going to the workforce, who are just as amazing and just as important. And to the students that have no idea what they're doing, that is totally okay, because you will have all the same opportunities in a year or a couple months from now as you do right now. Don't rush into a career path you don't want. Be who you are, and everything around you will fall into place. Now we're going to get a little cheesy here, especially for our 13-year seniors. To quote our proud song from elementary school, I am proud of who I am, proud of what I am, proud of where I'm going, and proud of what I'm doing. And I'm proud that I can finally say those words and mean it. Congratulations, class of 2022. We did it. Thank you.
Senior choir, please come forward. Thank you. please rise.
Jaden Thomas Allen. Jaden is graduating as a Gold Scholar and will be attending Missouri State University, where he will be majoring in theater education. Jay is also enlisted in the National Guard and has an 8-year contract. Jay plans to enroll in ROTC during his sophomore year at Missouri State. Logan Blake Anderson. Logan is a Gold Scholar and will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where he will be majoring in computer science. Jacob Michael Alt. Jacob will be attending the Tiger Pathways program and will use his A-plus scholarship to complete his general studies degree. He then plans to transfer to the University of Missouri Columbia to earn a bachelor's degree in sports management. Isabel Christine Ost. Isabel will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where she will be majoring in English. Alan John Austin. AJ is graduating with summa cum laude and Gold Scholar honors. He will be attending William Jewell College, where he will be majoring in accounting and playing football. Brody Oliver Baker. Brody will be attending Rankin Technical College and completing the Certified Dealership Technician Program. Mafalda Balabona. Mafalda will be returning to Portugal and attending the Nova Medical School, where she will be attending medical school. Dakota Ray Bashirs. Dakota will be entering the workforce and working at his family's business, 1839 Tap House. Cody John Betts. Cody will be entering the workforce in the field of auto mechanics or attend Grand River Welding Institute. Lauren Kate Blakemore. Lauren is graduating with summa cum laude and Gold Scholar honors. She will be attending Kenyon College, where she will be double majoring in history and education and also playing volleyball. Olivia Beth Bloomer. Upon graduation, Olivia will be entering the workforce. Josephine Elizabeth Bolte. Josephine is graduating with magna cum laude and gold scholar honors. She will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where she will be majoring in pre-medicine. Benjamin Christopher Boyle. Ben is graduating with cum laude and gold scholar honors. He will be attending State Technical College and using his A-plus scholarship to major in commercial turf and grounds management. William Matthew Bramer. William is graduating with magna cum laude honors and will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where he will be majoring in chemistry. Caitlin Eileen Casey. Caitlin is graduating with summa cum laude and gold scholar honors. She will be attending the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, where she will be majoring in astronomy. Haley Jo Charlton. Upon graduation, Haley will be entering the workforce. Virginia Marie Clark. Virginia will be attending the Capitol Academy on a paid internship to begin her career in the construction industry. Carson Tiger Cobb. Tiger is graduating with cum laude honors and will be attending the University of Wisconsin-La Crosse, where he will be majoring in elementary education and playing football. Evan Lane Crabtree. Evan will be attending Moberly Area Community College, where he will be completing his degree in general studies. Kale Walton Crane. Upon graduation, Kale will be entering the workforce. Clancy Catherine Crawford. Clancy will be graduating with summa cum laude and gold scholar honors. She will be attending John Wood Community College in Quincy, Illinois, where she will complete her Associate's of Science degree and play volleyball. She then plans to transfer to a four-year university and double major in aerospace engineering and computer science. Katrina Opal Crawford. Katrina will be attending Moberly Area Community College and using her A-plus scholarship to complete her emergency medical technician certificate. Olivia Laura Crawford. Olivia will be attending Moberly Area Community College and use her A-plus scholarship to major in business. Jenna Grace Crowder. Upon graduation, Jenna will be entering the workforce.
Seniors in the second row, please stand. Thank you.
Jacob Alexander Davis. Jacob will be attending State Technical College and using his A-plus scholarship to major in Networking Systems Technology. Karen Haley Fisher. Haley will be attending Moberly Area Community College, where she will be using her A-plus scholarship to complete her degree in General Studies. William Everett Kusner. William will be attending State Technical College and using his A-plus scholarship to major in Welding Technology. Madeline Danae Ganley. Madeline is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where she will be majoring in music education. Kendall Clay Gittler. Kendall will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where he will be majoring in Agriculture Systems and Technology. Zachary Ryan Gresham. Zach is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending Moberly Area Community College and then will transfer to the University of Central Missouri, where he will be majoring in Flight Operations Management. Audrey Nicole Hale. Audrey will be attending Moberly Area Community College and using her A-plus scholarship to major in veterinary technology. Carter Joe Hamilton. Carter is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending State Technical College and using his A-plus scholarship to major in Drafting and Design, Engineering and Technology. Garrett Ryan Vargas. Garrett will be attending Columbia College, where he will be majoring in Percentic Science and participating in track and field. Rachel Paige Vargas. Rachel is graduating with Magna Cum Laude and Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending William Jewell College, where she will be majoring in business. Thomas Franklin Harris. Thomas is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending the University of Missouri Science and Technology, where he will be majoring in Mechanical Engineering. Samuel Heffer. Samuel will be attending the University of Missouri Science and Technology, where he will be majoring in Mechanical Engineering. Mason Carl Verbal. Wow. Mason will be graduating with Cum Laude and Gold Scholar Honors and be attending Missouri State University, where he will be majoring in music education. Thank you. Reagan Anna Hurd. Reagan is graduating with magna cum laude and Gold Scholar honors and will be attending Columbia College, where she will be majoring in nursing. Trenton Tanner Hobbs. Trenton will be attending Moberly Area Community College and use his A-plus scholarship to complete his business management degree. Ashlyn Leslie Huff. Ashlyn is graduating with summa cum laude and Gold Scholar honors and will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia Honors College, where she will be majoring in psychology with a pre-med track. Jaylene Danielle Hudnut. Jaylene plans on attending the Paul Mitchell School in Columbia and will pursue her cosmetology license. Alexandria Elizabeth Hughes. Alexandra will be attending William Woods University, where she will be majoring in political studies with a pre-law track. Summa cum laude and Gold Scholar honors, and he will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia Honors College, where he will be majoring in engineering. Tyler Jacob King. Tyler will be attending the NASCAR Technical Institute, where he will complete his NASCAR technician and pit crew training. Adrienne Aisley Marie Leach. Jay will be attending Moberly Area Community College, where she will be majoring in business and fine arts. Jay also completed her cosmetology program at Davis Hart Career Center and will be working as a stylist at Hudson Hawk. Saxton Mitchell Lockwood. Saxton is graduating with Gold Scholar honors and will be attending Moberly Area Community College and using his A-plus scholarship to complete his general studies degree. Aiden Allen Lopez. Aiden will be attending Moberly Area Community College and using his A-plus scholarship to complete his business degree. Zoe McLean Lyons. Zoe is currently attending Moberly Area Community College and using her A-plus scholarship to major in business office administration.
Seniors in the third row, please stand.
Aiden March. Jack is graduating with magna cum laude and gold scholar honors and will be attending Columbia College, where he will be majoring in biochemistry with a pre-med track. Tanner Adam Martin. Tanner will be attending State Technical College and uses A-plus scholarship to major in heavy equipment operations. Nancy Rose Martinez. Upon graduation, Nancy will be entering the workforce. Karina Lissette Mayan Rosales. Karina will be attending the Tiger Pathway program and use her A-plus scholarship to pursue her associate's degree in nursing. She then plans to transfer to the University of Missouri Columbia to earn a bachelor's degree in nursing. Catherine Paige McCord. Upon graduation, Paige will enter the workforce as a licensed cosmetologist. Aaron Wesley Miller. Upon graduation, Aaron will be entering the workforce. Natalie Faith Mitchell. Natalie is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending Missouri State University, where she will be majoring in interior design. Chase Morris. Chase will be attending the Tiger Pathway program and will use his A-plus scholarship to pursue his associate's degree in general studies. He then plans to transfer to the University of Missouri Columbia to earn a degree in sports management. Jackson Amon Morton. Jackson is graduating with summa cum laude and gold scholar honors and will be attending the University of Michigan, where he will be majoring in computer science. Riley Morris Nichols III. Riley is graduating with magna cum laude and gold scholar honors and will be attending Columbia College, where he will be majoring in business administration. Brooklyn Reeds Onan. Brooklyn will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where she will be majoring in architecture and interior design. Avery Reagan Edding. Avery is graduating with summa cum laude and gold scholar honors. She will be attending Culver Stockton College, where she will be majoring in sports management and playing basketball. Kaylin Marie Duncan. Graduation, Kaylin will be entering the workforce as a 911 dispatcher with Boone County Joint Communication. Hayden Frederick Lewis Orshlin. Hayden will be attending Mobley Area Community College and uses A-plus scholarship to complete his general studies degree. After that, Hayden then plans to transfer to State Technical College to complete his commercial turf and grounds management. Emma Grace Parnell. Emma is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending Missouri State University, where she will be majoring in elementary education. Isabel Louise Peterson. Isabel is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending St. Louis University, where she will be majoring in biology. Cody Albert Plowman. Cody will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where he will be majoring in biology. Madison Kelly Plummer. Madison is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending Maryville University, where she will be majoring in Forensic Psychology. Chloe Ann Quintana. Chloe will be attending Mobley Area Community College and will use her A-plus scholarship to pursue her associate's degree in general studies. She then plans to transfer to the University of Missouri Columbia to earn a degree in art education. Lindsay Brooke Reinhardt. Lindsay will be attending St. Louis Community College and use her A-plus scholarship to complete her biology degree. Joshua Alexander Rooker. Josh will be attending Kreider's Institute of Welding Technology, where he will complete the Master Welding Program. Kylie Elizabeth Ryan. Kylie is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where she will be majoring in nursing. Paige Sasser. Paige will be attending St. Louis Community College and use her A-plus scholarship to complete her early childhood education degree. Joshua Curtis Savage. Josh is graduating with Gold Scholar Honors and will be attending State Technical College and uses A-plus scholarship to major in HVAC technology.
Seniors on the fourth row, please stand.
Mitchell Jean Zimmerman. Mitchell will be attending State Technical College and uses A-plus scholarship to major in electrical distribution systems. Abby Lynn Smith. Abby will be attending Stevens College, where she will be double majoring in education and psychology. Gavin Lee Smith. Upon graduation, Gavin will be entering the workforce. Tucker Lee Snelling. Tucker will be attending the American Welding Academy to complete his welding certification. Gracie Ann Tonius. Gracie will be attending Columbia College, where she will be majoring in nursing. Haley Ann Van Skyke. Haley is graduating with magna cum laude honors and will be attending Central Methodist University, where she will be majoring in business. Alex Russell Vaughn. Upon graduation, Alex will be entering the workforce running his Wolbeck & Sons Mowing and Landscaping Company. Alexis Marie Beers. Alexis, upon graduation, Alexis will be attending the University of Missouri Columbia, where she will be majoring in information technology and library science. Abigail Mackenzie Wade. Upon graduation, Abby will be entering the workforce. Garrett Addison Wade. Garrett will be attending the Tiger Pathways program and will use his A-plus scholarship to pursue his Associate of Fine Arts degree. He then plans to transfer to the University of Missouri Columbia to earn a degree in film studies. Jordan Lynn Waller. Upon graduation, Jordan will be working at Image Makers as a licensed cosmetologist. Kiera Olivia Warren Cutler. Kiera will be attending Mobley Area Community College to complete her general studies degree. Lydia Ann Whitekemper. Lydia is graduating with Gold Scholar honors and will be attending Columbia College, where she will be majoring in nursing. Alexander Raymond White. Alex will be attending State Technical College and uses A-plus scholarship to major in precision machinery technology. Noah Lane Little. Noah will be attending State Technical College and uses A-plus scholarship to major in heavy equipment operations. Jackson Gene Wise. Upon graduation, Jackson will be entering the workforce. He will be welding for Evolution Fabrication.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present to you the graduating class of 2022.